In 2008, a revolution came to the Indian motorcycle market, and that revolution was the Yamaha FZ. And now, after 11 years, Yamaha has launched its third version of the FZ. The version 3.0 sees many changes from its predecessor version 2.0. A split LED headlight setup has replaced the traditional halogen headlamp. Although the pilot lamp is still a halogen lamp, which is kind of a bummer. They could have kept it an LED to keep it on track. The mudguard comes from the FZ25. The tank has been redesigned and you get chrome finishes on the air intakes. In fact, the tank has gone more wider. The handlebar has been raised and the switches on the handlebar are from the FZ25. You get a new instrument cluster in the bike. In fact, the mirror design has changed from the past versions. So Yamaha has focused to make this bike more city friendly and a sports commuter. They call it an urban fighter. If you see, the seats are no more split. You get a single seat and you get more area for a pillion. You get a single grab rail on the back instead of the two in the previous version. The backside has also been redesigned. There have been few changes in the silencer design. And now you get a rear disc brake. So that means no more drum in FZ. Mechanically, there have been not much changes in the bike. The engine is still 149.5cc fuel injected engine, which comes from the version 2 FZs. But now you get a single channel ABS in the version 3.0, which enhances your braking power. I cannot really wait any longer, you know, just going around this bike. Overall, the bike feels very smooth while riding. The engine is very refined, as it has always been with Yamaha. The bike has a very good punch in the lower range or the lower RPMs, that is somewhere below 4000 RPM. In the mid-range also, the bike performs very well. However, there is no such thing as a top end or a top range to this bike. We tried pushing this bike somewhere near to 110 km/h, but I feel that is the place where it maxes out, somewhere around 9000 RPM. It is better to drive it on 70s and 80s, which is a more comfortable speed for city driving. Once you try to push the bike beyond 80 km/h, you get to feel significant amount of vibration on the handlebars. The motorcycle is offered with a 5-speed gearbox, which has been there in the previous versions. The clutch is on a lighter side. When riding in the cities, you tend to meet few of the potholes on the roads, and the front forks deal with it very well. However, the rear monoshock is on a stiffer side, which definitely gives you a better control on the corners. But then for cities, it is better that you get a softer monoshock for comfortable rides. Coming to the braking power of this bike, well, the rear drums are gone. There is a disc in the back. There is a single channel ABS in the front. Definitely, this bike gives you a lot of confidence while braking, and the braking power has gone significantly up. So this is the FZ version 3.0. With all these changes, it has put on a bit weight, but it is still the lightest street fighter available in the Indian market. The FZ is priced at 95,000 ex showroom, and for 2,000 rupees more, you can get the FZS. This makes the overall price of the bike 13,000 more than the predecessor, and it is the most expensive street fighter you can get in the market. But someone has truly said, if FZ wouldn't have existed, I really don't know RTR, NS or Hornet would have ever existed. So on that note, it's time to end this review. I hope you did like this video. I hope you have already pressed the like button. Do subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Leave your precious feedbacks in the comment section below. You can also get in touch with us on Facebook, on Instagram or Twitter. We would love to hear it from you, how you like the FZS version 3.0. Meet you in the next video. Till then, keep riding and be safe. Bye bye.